Hello and welcome to Abubu's Teacup video for Center of the Earth. My name is George and today we're going to see how we made this delicious traditional Japanese green tea. We're also going to brew the tea at the same time, so if you're one of our Tea Club members and you've already received your Tea Club box, then please feel free to brew alongside. So, if you need to get some teaware, now is the moment to hit pause, collect the teaware on screen, and then hit play, and we can carry on and we can brew together whilst we watch the process of making this delicious tea. Today's tea, Center of the Earth, was a last minute substitution as our original selection had been damaged too much in the late frost in April. Many of the farmers in Wazuka lost much of their first harvest to this late frost, and it's been quite difficult this year so far. Fortunately, it was not all lost, as there were other cultivars which not had yet grown enough to be able to be damaged by the frost, so we were still able to harvest those. And that leads me to our next cultivar and our today's tea, which is Center of the Earth. This is a variety called Zairai, and the tea bushes have a different genetic material throughout the field, which gives it a more varied flavour depending on where it's grown throughout Japan. Before we see one of the beautiful tea fields, let's start preparing for the brew. We'll be brewing the first infusion at about 75 degrees Celsius for 90 seconds and 150 millilitres of water. It's always great to see such beautiful tea fields. And now the pitcher is feeling quite hot to the touch, but not too hot. So this is about 75 degrees Celsius, and this is good for our first infusion. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take one packet, which is 5 grams from our Tea Club box. And we're going to open this tea and pour all of the leaf into the teapot. Beautiful leaf. This matte white Futanashi Kyusu is better for inspecting the colour in the tea leaf before and after the brewing as well. So it's a very easy way to assess the tea. This leaf has an almost wild green colour. Now, to pour the water, we want to pour evenly and gently over all of the leaves. While we wait, let's take a look at the first few machines. We have a timer, so please don't worry. Thank you. It's time to pour the tea. So when we're pouring the tea, I'm going to pour it into this pitcher. And we want to pour gently and smoothly. It looks good. And it will taste good too. The last drops contain the most flavor, so we want to make sure we get as many of those as possible. Let's smell the kisu. So the aroma in the kisu is really floral, and it almost has a little bit of hay in there as well, but very floral. Sweet, the first notes I get a sweetness and a fresh floral notes in the middle, with the end is quite strong actually. It's almost it's quite honeysuckle at the end. So that's a really interesting combination. Really tasty tea. While we enjoy this tea, let's watch the last few machines in the factory. Okay, so now you've seen how Centre of the Earth has gone from our beautiful tea field all the way through to the delicious tea that's in your cup. I hope you all enjoyed, and thank you very much for watching to this point. You're amazing. If you want to see how we make more of our teas, then click the subscribe button and hit the bell icon as well. If you need more tea videos now, then head to our channel and you can see how we made more of this year's tea. See you next time. Oishi. Hontou ni mechou oishi.